So guys, we are truly, right, four ordinary guys, yeah. regular guys,
yeah.
who love God, love our fans, and want to inspire and encourage our fans. And we're really excited to be sitting here to tell you about this opportunity and what we're doing, which is a documentary. You can go to StryperDocumentary.com, find out everything about it, and see what's going on, see what's going to go on. You're going to be a part of it. Your stories, that's what's going to make this special. That's what's going to make this incredible. And we're so excited for this opportunity. We can't even tell you how excited we are. We've been called many things over the years, right?
Yep.
We've been called freaks.
Heavy metal Bible bashers.
Born again hard rockers.
I've heard the bumblebee thing forever.
You know why? We used to wear those carpets.
Yeah, bees have that pollen around their legs.
Yeah, yeah.
I never thought of it as
what it was.
STRYPER has become America's preeminent heavy metal band, rocking for Jesus.
We were playing the club scene, Kazaris, the Troubadour, the Whiskey.
We gave our lives to the Lord. It just clicked. This is real. We want to change the music industry by invading it. People were telling me, that's going to be impossible. To try to do something with rock music and Christianity combined, no way.
It really wouldn't matter what anybody thought or said. What mattered was what God was going to do with us.
It's been difficult for people to figure out who we are, why we are, and what we are. Are we mainstream? No. Do we fit into the CCM club? Not really. A lot of Christian bands kind of grew up in the church, not on the streets of Hollywood.
I just love that sound, all the harmonies. I've always been a big harmony guy. Met the guys back in 1985. Got to open for them at a show in Charlotte, North Carolina. They spent a lot of time with us and we were nobodies. To be playing for them is just a freaking dream come true, man.
Rock audiences pick up the fact that these guys do rock and roll, and they rock and roll with the best of them.
We played with bands like Quiet Riot, Rat, Wasp, Poison. We did a show with Bon Jovi. We played with bands like Anthrax, Raven. And we've always had this motto of we'll play anywhere, anytime, with anyone.
It's funny how I run into a lot of established artists from our day that'll say, oh yeah, we listen to STRYPER. And it's like, wow, okay.
Well, it is true that we do throw Bibles in the crowd. I've been told close to a quarter million.
So many people were encouraged to surrender their lives to God, get involved in church.
Jimmy Swagger started sending his people out to our shows, protesting with bullhorns and telling people don't go in, they're of the devil.
We're just being ourselves. We're having the courage to stand up and say, look, you don't have to give up your personality, give up sin.
You know, it might have been easier to have success if we hadn't have gone this route.
I thought I had this perfect band. We're all sitting around the studio in the mixing room. The lyrics are just booming through, and all of a sudden we hear, Jesus is the way. My initial reaction was, oh no.
You know, maybe we could have got played on the air more, but we felt so strongly about this that we decided to take the chance.
We didn't have a plan. We just did it.
I think as my faith grew, I began to see this was a calling.
And that's eternal.
That's the glue that keeps us together. It's the best glue ever, because when you surrender everything to God, nothing can stop you.
Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much for letting us be a part of your world and for being a part of our world for 34 years. By the time this comes out, it might be 36 years, right? Is this going to be like 2 years in the making or something?
We love all of you. We really do. We thank you for everything.
You guys are amazing, and you sustain us and you support us. You've been there through it all with us, and it's amazing, and we're blessed to be able to do this, so we can't wait.